her.
Wallace.
Oh, sorry. So weird seeing you here.
Yeah, really weird. Where have you just come in from?
Taiwan.
You've been in Taiwan this whole time?
Yeah, I was. And then I was doing some traveling with my fiance.
You got engaged?
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah, no, me too.
Oh.
I don't know why I did that. I have nothing on this hand. So who is the incredibly lucky guy?
Just this dude who stalked me all the way to Taiwan.
It's such a coincidence, because I actually followed my fiance to Taiwan as well, but I made out with her sister first, because I'm a badass.
Come in.
He's a real doctor. He finished his degree.
Alan, in Asia. We're not Asian.
It's legitimate medical training.
Wine, please.
Here, ask him.
After you have a baby, if you eat the placenta, does it count as cannibalism?
You know that's not really a medical question, right?
If a baby's hand is bigger than its face, will it have cancer?
No, it just means your baby has massive hands.
Oh. What's going on here? Oh.
Jesus.
Oh, it smells bad. Wait, can you write us a prescription or not?
Oh. There goes my husband. I can't believe you have a husband. It's crazy.
You're weirding me out.
So...
Careful. Give me your hand.
You're basically up here alone, like a total loser.
Yeah, but who's the bigger loser? Me for escaping up here or you for agreeing to marry me?
No, that's me. If I fell, do you think I'd die or just become massively paralyzed?
Probably just paralyzed.
You'd be so screwed. Because you'd have to stay married to me, because if you didn't, people would be like, he divorced his wife immediately after she became paralyzed from the waist down.
From the waist down?
Yeah.
But so everything would still work down there, though, right?
Yeah. I mean, I wouldn't be able to feel anything, but...
I really don't even need you to feel anything now. I don't want the sex to be too good right away.
Mm-hmm.
I'm intentionally being much worse in bed than I actually am, so that it can just keep getting better and better forever.
But, like, very slowly over many, many decades, so that we hit our sexual peak in our 90s.
Yeah. That's the plan, actually. Is if the last time we have sex is also the best, and that it actually kills you.
That wouldn't be such a bad way to go.
We'd probably head back down soon, right?
Yes.
We could stay here for another minute.
Or maybe, like, forever.